Good morning, children. Today, again, we'll take up some problems related to average speed, average velocity. The first problem is in a journey, a car travels at the rate of 20 किलोमीटर पर आवर फॉर 10 मिनट्स एंड देन एट 30 किलोमीटर पर आवर for 20 minutes. Find first the total average distance traveled by the car. Find total distance traveled by the car in second the average speed of the car during right. So here V1 is given 20 minutes per kilometer per hour and T1 is given 10 minutes. So since the speed is given in kilometer per hour, so we have to change the time into hours. It will be 10 over 60 means 1 by 6 hours. Right, and V2 is given 30 kilometer per hour, and T2 is given 20 minutes. Again, we have to change according to hours. So it will give us what 1/3 hours, right? So for first part, we have to calculate the total distance traveled by the car. So first V1 must be equal to, suppose in first part, first 10 minutes, the distance traveled by the car is S1. So V1 must be equal to S1. So it will give us S1 equals V1 into T1. V1 is 20 km per hour and time is 1 by 6. So it will give you 10 by 3 km. Right? And similarly, V2 must be equal to S2 over T2. S2 is the distance traveled in next 20 minutes. So it means S2 equals V2 into T2. So it equals 30 into 1 by 3. It means 10 kilometers. Right? So it means total distance traveled S must be equal to S1 plus S2. 10 by 3 plus 10 will give you 3 in your LCM. 10 plus 30 means 40 by 3. So it will be nearly 10.34 kilometer. So again. Right. Second case, we have to calculate what? We have to calculate the average speed. And average speed we know. equals total distance traveled upon total time taken. The total time taken is suppose t. T must be equal to t1 plus t2. T1 is 1 by 6 and yes, T1 is 1 by 6 and T2 is 1 by 3. So 6 in your LCM, it will give you 1 plus 2, which means 3 by 6 means how much? Clear? So now, average velocity, V average equals S1 plus S2 divided by T1 plus T2, S1 plus S2, we have calculated 40 by 3 upon half. So by reciprocal, this 2 will go up. So it will give you 40 into 2 upon 3. So it will give you nearly 26.68 kilometers per hour. Clear? Right? Next problem is a particle moves along a circle of radius r. It starts from A and moves in anti-clockwise direction. Calculate the distance traveled by the particle first from A to B second A to C third A to D fourth in one complete revolution. Also calculate displacement in each case. Each case as from the given figure. So here, particle moving along a circular track of radius r. Suppose this is a circular track. This is center support and this is point A. point B, this is B, and this is point C, and this is R, this is also R, so this is basically R, and this is also the R. Here, so drag is circular and radius is R. So it means circumference of the circle, of the drag, you can say, equals 2 pi r, right? In first case, we have to find out the distance traveled by the particle from A to B, right? So distance traveled from A to B equal, so this is the circumference, so it means this part AB chord will be 1 by 4 of circumference. Right, so it will be 1 by 4 into 2 pi r, which means this pi r by 2, right? Okay, now for displacement, from A to B. As I said to you, displacement is the shortest distance between two points, right? So shortest distance between two points, I have already said to you, this will be a straight line. So you see the triangle from triangle OAB. OAB is the right angle triangle having two sides equals R, perpendicular as well as base. So it means AB is the displacement. It must be equal to OA square plus OB square. So this equals square root of R square plus R square means root 2R square. So it will give us displacement square root of 2r square is r root 2. Clear? Now second case, distance traveled from A to C. Right, so from A to C means this part A, B, and C. So from the diagram, it is clear that it must be equal to half into circumference. So it is half into 2 pi r. So it will give you pi r. You understand, sir? Right. Now, displacement from A to C. So, displacement from A to C will be again the shortest distance between these two points. And shortest distance between these two points is a straight line. It must be equal to AC. And from diagram, it is clear that it is AO plus OC. AO is R, OC is also R, so it will be 2R. Clear? Other thing, from A to B, distance traveled from a to b. So 1 by 4 circumference is this, 1 by 4 is then 1 by 4 will be this. So it means it is 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4. It means it is 3 by 4 into circumference. Clear? Right? So it means the 3 by 4 into 2 pi r. Let's cancel this by 2 times. It will be 3 by 2 pi r. Okay? And now displacement. From A to B. Again, displacement is the shortest distance between two points. So here this will be A, B. And from triangle, again this angle will be 90. So from triangle AOD, what is AD? This is R, this is also R. It means base is R and perpendicular is also R. It must be equal to root AO square plus OD square. AO is R, so AO square is R square plus R square equals root 2 R square, or AD equals R root 2. Clear? And fourth part, distance traveled in one complete revolution. The distance covered in one complete revolution means this plus this plus this plus this. It means it equals circumference. And circumference, you know, this is 2 pi r. And displacement will be how much? In 6 seconds, where OP equals 360 meter and OQ equals 240 meter. What are the average velocity and average speed? Of the car when going first from O to P. And second from O to P, and back to Q. Okay. So here the situation is like this. This is O suppose, and this is P, and this distance is given 360 meters here, and P to Q, this is Q, and OQ is given 240 meters.
Good morning, sir.
OP equals 360 meters, OQ 240 meters. So it means it is clear from the diagram that this portion will be 120 meters. 240 plus 120 equals 360. So it means OP equals 120. Right? The first part we have to find out average velocity and average speed from O to P. So suppose time taken from O to P is T1 and it is given 18 seconds. Right? So now average velocity equals displacement over time. Displacement is from O to P, a straight line. Displacement will be 360 meter. Time is given 18 seconds, so it will give you 20 meter per second. Right? And average speed equals total distance traveled over total time. From O to P, displacement and distance are same, right? So it is 360 over 18, so it will also be 20 meter per second. Now second case, average speed and average velocity from O to P and back to Q. In this case, displacement will be how much? Initially, the body starts from O, goes to P, and then coming back to Q. Right? So, what will be the displacement? Displacement will be actually OQ only. So, displacement is OQ, and OQ is 240 meters. And what is the time taken? Time T2. 18 seconds takes to go from O to P and 6 seconds to takes from P to Q. So time is a scalar quantity. So it will simply be 18 plus 6 equals 24 seconds. Clear? So it means average velocity equal displacement over time. Displacement here 240 and time is 24, so it will be 10 meter per second. But for average speed, what is distance traveled? Distance means the total length of the path covered. So first body goes from O to P and then P to Q. So distance must be equal to OP plus PQ. OP is 360, and PQ is 120. So it will be 480 meter. Yeah. And time will remain same, 24 seconds. So average speed equals total distance over total time. Total distance is 480. Total time taken is 24 seconds. So it will give you 20 meter per second. Clear? You okay? So next problem is on a 100 meter track, a train moves the first 50 kilometers. 100 kilometers. A train moves the first 50 kilometers with a uniform speed of 50 kilometers per hour. How fast must the train travel? The next 50 kilometers. So as to have an have average speed of 60 kilometer per hour for the entire trip. Right. So in this problem, there are two parts of the problem. First part, say S1 equal to 50 kilometer. Here the train is moving with a constant speed of 50 kilometer per hour. So we know speed equals distance over time. So it means time equals distance over speed. Distance is given, so here it will be S1 over V1. 50 upon 50 kilometer per hour, it means it takes 1 hour. Right? For next part, S2 is also 50 kilometer. And let train move with V2 speed. So it means this is supposed T1. T2 must be equal to S2 over V2, and S2 is given 50, so it will be 50 over V2. That is equation number one. Now it is given the average speed of the train should be 60 kilometer per hour, right? So V average is given 60 kilometer per hour, and you know V average equals S1 plus S2 divided by T1 plus T2. Yeah? Right? So it means T1 plus T2 must be equal to S1 plus S2 upon V average. S1 plus S2, S1 is 50 kilometer, S2 is also 50 kilometer, but it is 100. And average speed is even 60, so it will give you 5 by 3 hours. And this is total time T. So it means T1 we have calculated 1 hour. So it means 5 by 3 hours must be equal to T1 is 1 plus T2 is 50 over V2. So it means 50 over V2 equals 5 by 3 over, sorry, 5 by 3 minus 1. So 5 by 3 minus 1 means 2 by 3. Here, it means now cross multiply, it will give us 50 into 3 must be equal to 2v2, or 2v2 equal to 50 into 3, or v2 equal to 50 into 3 is 150 upon 2. So it will be 75 kilometers.